Samurai Jack is an animated series that started way back in August of 2001, ending after 4 seasons and 52 episodes. This is about to change as the series is set to receive a new season in the next year or so. I wasn't the biggest fan of the series, although I did catch some episodes at the time, so I had to look up some of the details on the show. Samurai Jack was apparently sent to the future, becomes a hero in his quest to return to his proper time period, and I guess there's a bit of saving the world. That's the short end of it anyway, although I'm sure one of you out there will fill in the details and tell me what I got wrong in that long run-on sentence. Others of you are probably wondering why I'm bothering with a Samurai Jack video since a game called Samurai Jack: The Shadow of a Coup was released back in March of 2004. Well, that title was developed by Adrenium Games, who clearly got the license. This prototype, however, was developed by Visionscape Interactive, the same company that did the Sonic Extreme pitch that you can find on the channel. It was built on August 19th, 2002, and actually has bits of the cancelled Rocket Power game located in its files. It's clearly another early pitch, and not anything meant to be seen by the public. Based on the August 2002 build date, it was likely around that time period that Cartoon Network, or whomever was involved with licensing Samurai Jack, was entertaining pitches for the license. Obviously, the game is a bit janky and pretty crap, but this is typical for many pitches, which I say for every single one of these videos, but some people seem to forget. All that you can do in this little demo is run around, if you can call it that. Swing a sword and jump a bit. The game doesn't really try to imitate the show's unique style of animation, but the final game released by that other developer is fairly simplistic as well. There are a few different versions of the world in the files, the primary one being kind of dark. Another version, likely earlier, has water that looks quite different. And this last version hidden in the files actually looks a bit better than that first version that I showed, but it doesn't seem to function that well as it's hard to get around the world. A very basic debugging mode is available as well, but there isn't really anything to write home about. We know that Visionscape didn't get the license, so they didn't continue working on this game. This one is pretty cut and dry. I know we gained a lot of new subscribers from the Metallica videos, so do stick around, hit that subscribe button, because there is a ton of new content coming, including something that involves a family of Kongs. Until next time, thanks for watching.